Shabbos Daf Kuf Mem. Today's email comes from Micha Holzer from Cincinnati, Ohio. I listen to the 8-minute daf on my way to work. It's mekadesh my drive and my whole day. The clarity of the presentation helped the holy words penetrate into my neshama. I agree with all the sentiments of the emails that you read during the daf. I would like to join your siyum on Shabbos, Baruch Hashem. We're pushing 80 different locations for the siyum on Masechta Shabbos. I've never gotten this far in the daf, and the daf helped me stay positive and kept my family and I going through this whole current kufa, which started around Daf Ches on Shabbos. Continue being lahagdol Torah la'adira. Thank you, Micha Holzer. We're talking about mustard seeds, and before Shabbos, you started kneading them, you added water. On Shabbos, you want to add water. According to Rav, you're permitted to do so with a kli, because that's the shinoi. According to Shmuel, with your hand, because that's the shinoi. According to Rabbi Yochanan, both of them are usur, and that's how Abai and Rav paskin. But the halacha, you're allowed to mix them with a kli with your hand, as long as you do it easily, and you don't do it really hard, and then afterwards you add a little bit of honey, and that's great. The same halacha applies to kress. You could add afterwards oil and vinegar. And the Gemara tells us that mint is really good for it. Same halacha applies to if you crushed garlic. You're allowed to add beans and split beans. Now going back to the mustard, Abaye's mother, stepmother, made this for him. She added the water on Shabbos, and he refused to eat from it. The wife of Reb Zeira, which Reb Nissim Gani says in Daf Kuf Tes, is actually, she was married now to Reb Chiya. She made Reb Chiya, and he wouldn't eat from it, and she said, well, your Rebbe ate from it. Ravina himself would take the stalk of the garlic and mix it, and he would eat from it. The Mishnah says you can make a drink called anumilin, which consists of wine, honey, and pepper. The reason why you're allowed to make it, because it's for drinking, not for refuah. However, alentis is made more for refuah, so it's usur. It's made out of aged wine, clear water, and balsam. And people drink it after they come out of the bathhouse to cool them down. Rabbi Yosef drank from this, and he loved it. He said, if I had one more cup, according to Rashi, he would leave this world, and he would have to have schusim in order to keep him alive. But Mar Ukva, who gave him the drink, was so used to drinking it, it didn't have that effect on him. Says the Mishnah, Rabbi Yosef says, Asaferia, you could soak it in, you should not allow to soak it in warm water. Rabbi Yochanan asked Rabbi Yanai, what's the halach of soaking? He said, even in cold water. And Rabbi Yochanan said, but from the Mishnah's mashma, in cold water it's okay. He said, if so, why am I your Rebbe? Why am I better than you? I also thought about the Mishnah. The Mishnah is a Das Yachid. According to the Tanakhama, it's permitted. If you do soak this asafetida in water, according to Ravada, Yerchayv HaChatos, according to Abaya, it's only the Rabbanon of Uvdin Dechol. Why do people drink it? They drink it to get rid of their chest pains. Now, according to everybody, if you started on a dosage of this and you started taking it on Thursday and Friday, if you would stop taking it on Shabbos, it would be a tremendous sakara. Therefore, you're allowed to even soak it on Shabbos in cold water. You put it in the sun to warm it up. You're allowed to add vinegar to this asafetida, and you're not allowed to float vetch. In other words, add water, and it causes the exterior peel to raise to the top. That's bayir. You're not allowed to rub the vetch with your fingers. Again, that's bayir. Well, you're not allowed to put straw on a higher place and let the sifter do its job by itself, but you're allowed to put it into the sifter and walk with it, walk over to the animal's trough and put it in, and whatever happens, happens by itself. It's dav shenim skaven, according to Reb Shimon, is mutter. According to Reb Elazar ben Yaakov, that would be aser. You're allowed to rub linen in order to make it softer, because what you're doing is you're not trying to make it whiter and cleaner, you're trying to make it softer, and that's okay. But when it comes to a head scarf, that is aser, because what you're trying to do is make it whiter. In those days, they would put a piece of wood, like a twig, in a shirt instead of a hanger. That twig is muksim machmas gufay, so you're not allowed to touch the twig, but you're allowed to move the shirt, take the shirt off the twig. Now, if it's a stick that's a klishim alachta l'isr, like a weaver's rod, then you're permitted to move it, letzarech mekaymai. If you have different herbs that are not royal achila sodom, people don't eat it, but it's royal for behema, so it's not mukta, but if it's not royal behema, it is mukta. Rav Katina says, if you sit down on a bed that's used by a couple, it could bring to Yerurim, and that's also, it's like being mizana, and the Gemara says, we don't have to worry about it. Rav Chisda gave many, many life lessons to his Talmidim, and some of them to his own daughters. And he said, when you're buying vegetables and they come in a bunch, the circumference is always the same, so make sure that you get longer vegetables, you get more for your money. the different Chassam Sofer, different people say different pshat and what he meant by that, and all these following things. If a person doesn't have bread, he shouldn't eat vegetables, they make him hungrier. And he said himself, when I was poor, I wouldn't eat vegetables because it made me hungrier, and when I was wealthier, I wouldn't eat vegetables because I want to fill myself up with meat and fish. If a person is poor, he should wait until he has enough bread to make him satiated. He shouldn't eat smaller pieces. And if he doesn't have a lot of bread, he shouldn't cut the bread and break bread, because then he wouldn't give out to his guests with an ayin yafa. When he was poor, he would check the whole basket to see that he has enough to give enough to everybody. And he says that if you don't have enough money, don't buy expensive bread that's made out of wheat. Buy the barley that's about tashkas if you buy the expensive stuff. Rav Papa said something similar. Rav Papa said that if you could drink beer, why spend your money on wine? That's about tashkas. And the Gemara says that's not true. Baal tashkas is the gufa adam. It's better to take care of your own body than to save money. If a person doesn't have oil to put on his hands before Mayim Achrayinim, he could take algae out of a puddle. If a person that doesn't have money could buy the neck of an animal, it has three flavors. It's fatty, lean, and it has sinews. He told his Talmidim, buy these expensive shirts from Nahar Abba. Wash them every 30 days. I guarantee you your money back that they'll last you for a year. The reason why it's called a Kitainas shirt is because Kitana, it puts you up into another level, into another class. A person shouldn't say, he told his Talmidim, don't sit on hemp. It'll ruin your begadim. Don't give your clothes to the woman that's taking care of you, because she might see Carrie and she'll be disgusted. He told his daughters, you should be very tzinnias in front of your husbands. Don't eat a lot in front of them, they'll be grossed out. Don't eat vegetables before you go to sleep, it gives you bad breath. Or dates and beer at night, because that could ruin your stomach. Don't go to the bathroom in front of them, or even not in front of them, so they don't see it later. When somebody knocks on the door, don't use a Lashon Zohar, who is it? Say it in a Lashon Akeva. And he gave them advice how to play hard to get. Says the Mishnah, according to Reb Doisa, you're allowed to sweep out the trough of hay, move it to the side for the animal so that it doesn't get mixed in with dirt, etc. And you're allowed to move it away from the waste. Chacham say both of those things are aser, because first of all, you're not allowed to sweep the floor. It's mashu gumus, it's baina. And second of all, the food, in the second case, the food is mukta, it's disgusting. When we're discussing a trough that's attached to the ground, according to everybody, that is also because of mashu guma, is the whole machlokes is in a trough that the bottom is made out of wood. You're allowed to take food from a donkey and give it to an ox, because the donkey doesn't drool, and the opposite way, the ox does drool and the donkey won't eat it, so therefore, it's a tirchi yaseir on Shabbos, and that would be usher. Have a wonderful day.